everybody, I'm back. This is Sharon. I'm gonna do another chameleon painting. Chameleon cells, I guess you call it. Only this time I'm gonna make flowers. And how am I gonna do that? With my beautiful little rocket ship. What do you think of that? These are bamboo skewers. Now my bamboo skewers were very, very, very sharp at the end, okay? Because they're kebab skewers. So what I did is I took some utility scissors, I used trauma shears, and I just snipped the tops off just a little bit. So I don't know if you can see that or not, but they're kind of flat on the ends, and you want them a little bit flat on the ends because that's how you're gonna dip your silicone into your paint when the time comes, okay? And the way I'm gonna dip my silicone is to put it in the silicone that I have in the cup, dip it, go like that, and then probably put it over a paper towel to clean it off a little bit, and do it again, and we're gonna make flowers. Okay, y'all down with that? All right, so the first thing that we need to do is put some paint on the canvas. Now this is a 10 by 10 wrapped canvas, okay? It's dry, there's nothing on it. So what I'm gonna do is all these paints that I have here, I'm gonna randomly put them around on the canvas. I'm not gonna do lines this time because I want a little bit more variety. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started with that. Let me zoom you in a little bit so you can see. Maybe. There we go. Okay. So I didn't thin all of my paints down, and it says you're supposed to use paint and water, but I have Floetrol in mine, and I had this discussion in my last video. You're supposed to use paint and water, okay, but I have all these bottles of paint with Floetrol in them, and I did one my last video and it actually turned out pretty darn cool. So it will work. You just have to try and do what you need to do before any cells pop up. I was really lucky that no cells popped up because usually they do. So I'm just gonna put some different colors down that I would like to see in flowers. Okay, makes sense. Okay, this one's all goopy. All right. I'll try to put that more on the pink than the orange because I know pink and orange, or purple and orange, don't always mix too well. Oh, let me get the magenta in there first before I do the... Did I shake that or shake the other one? It's pretty sad when I don't remember, huh? Ooh, my magenta, it's really thick. But that's not gonna be an issue. So when I'm done putting all this paint on here, I'm going to swipe it, okay? In case you're wondering what the deal was, that's what's gonna happen. I'm going to swipe it. You know what, let's keep it in the pink category, shall we? Pinks and purples. I just brought all this paint out here because I didn't know what I was gonna do. Now this is metallic magenta, which is really pretty. Might be kind of cool to have a little metallic in there. So this is gonna end up being tipped a little bit, and then it's going to, let's see, what else can I use? I have, let's go with this metallic lilac. I'm watching painting videos as I do this, so. So my hope is that when I swipe this, it's gonna look pretty. All right, and I'm gonna take a little ivory. Well, I was, but it's all goobered up. Okay, and I'm gonna put ivory kind of in these holes here. I don't know, for some reason I really like ivory better than white sometimes. And you are gonna want your sides covered. And this is a lot of paint, and a lot of it's gonna end up coming off when I swipe it. I swiped it with a paper towel last time and it really took a lot of the paint off, so I'm gonna kind of get it over on the edges here. So I really kind of want some of this paint to come off because it's really too much to do what I want to do. But I think what I'm gonna do is just kind of get some over on these corners here. Try not to swipe it too much because I don't want to end up with mud. I don't know why I always call them corners. They're edges, okay? So let me get my edges covered. My corners, dang it. I was yelling at you, Ellie. Can you see my dog over there in her bed? No. Sometimes you can, depends on the angle of the camera. I just want to get a little paint on my edges just to give it a start here. Being left-handed. Alright, that should be good enough. Alright, you know what? I think I want some gloves. Do I want anything else in there? You know what? I think I should put some yellow in there because it really needs a little bit more contrast. Now hopefully this doesn't turn into an ugly muddy mess when I swipe it. But everything I do is an experiment, so. Get my get some paint on my edges. Well, I can't. Now, when I do the skewers dipping, it's gonna pull out the colors that are underneath. And what it does is it makes some really fabulous cells. But they're square instead of round. And it is really quite fascinating. You know what? I wonder if I can do it without swiping it. I'm gonna give it a quick try and see. Why not? Ain't gonna hurt, right? My life is an experiment. I gotta get rid of some of these paint bottles. Okay, I'm gonna have to get another paper towel for my skewer. Oh, well, no, wait a minute. Now this is Viva, so I can just turn it inside out, because Viva is, this stuff rock and rolls, let me tell you. All right, let me, well, that's kind of pretty. Let's see if we can't get this in a spot that you can see. That would be helpful, huh? Let me try this real quick without swiping it. Let me torch it first. Should be lots of bubbles. Try not to catch my paper towel on fire. Let's see what happens, shall we? Okay, I'm dipping it in my silicone. One stick that's a little on the small side. It's working. I think it would look better if I swiped it though. I really do. So let me do that. All right, let me move some of these paint bottles real quick. You know what? I'm gonna put some ivory up here, a little bit in the middle, and a little bit down here for swiping, okay? You can swipe it with or without, it doesn't matter. I've seen them do it with a black, a white, or you can use any color you want really to swipe with, but it really doesn't matter. I just want to get these paint bottles out of the way so I have some room. I have so many paint bottles, and I have 3 bins for them. I didn't put any silver in there. That's okay. Alright, so in order to do this, I'm going to need to move this up a little bit so I can swipe it. Alright, so I'm going to get my paper towel and spray her down. Make sure you get the end damp, because if you don't, if you have the part that you spread over the top, if the top isn't damp, then what you drag down over the painting is going to get a ridge in it. So make sure that your paper towel is completely soaked up a lot of paint, didn't it? That's all right. I'll just do what I did last time. I just took it and tipped it back down. Here's a little trick. You can move it along with your finger. It's not really going to matter what it looks like at this point, because you're gonna turn it into flowers, okay? Try not to get it muddy like I just did. See, I'm just trying to take it and grab it and pull it rather than smear it. But we're still gonna get flowers no matter what, so. And then I'm gonna take that paint and bring it back to the center. Sorry, you have to look at the back of it. Okay, so I'm getting this right here is from what I did previously with the silicone, so that's why that's doing that. But we're gonna go in now and do the flowers. I'm getting tired. I don't know if you can tell by my voice, but I'm getting kind of tired. It is 1:15 in the morning, that's why. Yeah, I need to go to bed, which I will be doing right after this. Okay, so now we're gonna do flowers. And I really don't need, I'll use one glove if I have to pull anything. Alrighty. Okay. So I've got my silicone right here. And I'm gonna dip it in there. A spot where I want it. Lay it right in there. Now, because there's silicone on my little tips here, it's not really staying on there, so I'm not getting any silicone. This is a little thick, so I'm going to take some of the stuff that I used last time. It's Rain-X and coconut milk. What I have only have in here is the coconut milk, but it is a little too thick. So let's try this. I mean, it's making the flowers, but it's just too thick. So I'm just going to grab the Rain-X. Let me put this up against the side here. Like I said, we're experimenting. This is what I do. I like to experiment. Alright, so I have glass Rain-X original. Okay, and that's what I used on the other one. If you watched it, it's greens and blues, and it turned out really, really pretty. I'm just gonna give this a little stir. I had to keep stirring my little bottle, or shaking my little bottle, so. But I think with a little bit thinner mixture of silicone, we're gonna have better results. Oh yeah. I can see it spreading a little bit better now, so that's good. Doesn't look like it's really doing anything, but it is. It just takes a little time for it to spread. What it's going to do is bring out all those colors that are underneath. All right, I think next time I'm going to swipe it with white or ivory. So there's more of a contrast. And hopefully you can see what's going on here. I hope. When I get more used to this, I'm gonna make something a little bit more organized, but right now I'm just plopping it on here because I'm not a real expert at this, so I guess if you could hold it there for a little bit and it'll drip down off of here. I'm just kind of shaking this around a little bit as I hold the skewers in there. I think it would be really cool if you swiped it with black and then took like one skewer and then just drew some kind of a painting, you know? But these do spread, so you are gonna get precise. Let that sit there for a minute and see what that does. I think I mentioned in another video that I've been vaping CBD oil for arthritis, and it actually really works. I don't know what y'all know about CBD oil, but it's made out of the hemp plant or marijuana plant, but it has no THC in it whatsoever. THC is the chemical in it that, well, I don't want to say chemical, it's the property in it that gets you high. Okay, but CBD oil does not have any THC in it whatsoever. So it doesn't get you high. Darn. Not kidding. No, I'm not. What am I kidding? I'm gonna step on the bandwagon here and say that smoking marijuana is so much better for you than some of the drugs these doctors give you. Unfortunately, some of the drugs that you do have to take are important, but as far as pain meds go and anti-anxiety medications go, smoking pot does just as good of a job. But unfortunately, you become impaired. And when you become impaired and you have to go and drive somewhere, that creates an issue. So CBD oil removes the THC and gives you all the properties that are left in it, which is very, very medicinal. Okay, CBD oil has shown to prevent seizures in epileptics. It has shown to give a good deal of relief to people that have chronic pain, and it helps relax people that have anxiety. I don't have anxiety, but I know some people that do, and it helps them tremendously. I don't think I got that side covered at all. I just got it all over my wrist. I guess I'll just get my fingers dirty. Why am I doing it with the hand that has no paint on it? Because I'm tired and I need to go to bed. Alrighty. Now we're cooking. I want to get this side done before this paint starts to dry up any. Bit off the bracelets. These bracelets have been through war with paint. There's so much paint in these bracelets, it's ridiculous. So, I don't know if you can see what we got so far here, but I think it looks pretty cool. It's very pretty. Show you. Kind of has a marbly effect. Now, doing it with this bamboo skewers on these colors doesn't really work very well. So next time what I'm going to do is I'm going to use black to swipe with, and then try doing the flowers, because I've seen it done. The person that I watched, Jennifer, she did it, and the results with black over the top were incredible. I'm gonna use some of this silicone or Rain-X and coconut milk, and I'm gonna go through and do a few spots here and there. Now, I don't know if you've ever used Rain-X before, but it really makes it go. It's pretty cool stuff. I am going to take what's left in here and pour it in here. This has a lot of coconut milk in it. All right. My hands are all slimy. Okay. Now, one thing I forgot about is metallics don't really fare that well with this technique, so we'll see what happens when we get this dry, and we'll see what our metallics look like. It's just kind of like alcohol inks. Sometimes the metallics kind of break down. I want to get some big ones going here. But, I mean, this is really pretty. Really, really pretty. Alright, I'm done. I think it's gorgeous. I'm gonna let it sit for a second. You can fast forward through it if you like, or watch it. Watch it do its thing. But I think the next time I'm not gonna use any metallics. I'm gonna bring you in a little bit so you can see what this looks like. Now if you want, you can watch it morph with me for a little bit and see what it's gonna do. I'm just gonna tidy up my sides a little bit here while I'm waiting for it to morph. I'm hoping it does anyway. It's absolutely beautiful. I mean, the colors and everything are gorgeous, but it didn't turn out the way I wanted to because the colors were so much the same. I didn't factor in that I needed way more contrast. So the next one I do, I am going to use black to swipe with. So I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of some bubbles. Now, one thing about this technique is when it dries and you go to varnish it, you're gonna really have to wash off a lot of silicone. Gonna be really, really slippery. So let's watch it morph here. Looks like it's kind of done doing its thing there. So anyway, that's what it looks like. Next video, I'm swiping with black and it is going to be fabulous. All right, that's it for now. I gotta go, it's 33 minutes and it's gonna cut off. So see you on the next one. Bye-bye.